Your reaction to this story: Raytheon has gone woke. America's second largest defense firm has told its staff to identify their privilege and give those with marginalized identities the floor during meetings. Raytheon is part of a Stronger Together campaign, urging workers to develop intersectional allyship in the workplace. Raytheon is calling on its employees to identify everyone's race to address racial injustice. Raytheon believes we really need to be striving for equity rather than equality. Your thoughts?
Bullshit. God damn it.
I'm gonna tell you,
the cover of this week's National Review magazine, the flagship of conservative America, is all about woke capitalism. Okay?
Yeah.
That's gonna be the Republicans' leverage to show just how truly and populist they are. They're going to go after, now they're going to be the party that goes after capital, even if they give big tax breaks to capitalists at the same time.
Yeah, let me show you one more story that I just thought was absolutely,
I wish I had had the magazine up here. I'd hold it up for everyone to see.
Yeah. So Jeff Bezos is now the wealthiest man in the world. His wealth has gone to $211 billion. On Tuesday, he made $8.4 billion as Amazon stock rose, right? Okay.
Jesus Christ.
So this is from, where is this from? This is from Politico today. The headline is, as Bezos called for tax hikes, remember when he was saying, yeah, raise our taxes, we don't pay enough in taxes. Amazon was lobbying to keep its tax bill low. This is from Politico. As Amazon publicly embraced Joe Biden's plan to raise the corporate tax rate across the board, it has also lobbied Congress to preserve a prized tax break that's helped it lower its corporate tax bill. This is from Politico. The retail giant's founder, Jeff Bezos, earned plaudits earlier this year when he announced that Amazon would back a rise in the corporate tax rate to help pay for Biden's infrastructure package. His comments broke with most of the rest of corporate America. The U.S. Chamber of Commerce and Business Roundtable vehemently opposed such tax hikes and served as a rejoinder to critics who have attacked Amazon for paying little to no federal income taxes.
Well, the Obama people did not go into West exec. They all went into Amazon, huh? That's what I get the feeling.
Jay Carney is a spokesman for Amazon. He used to be a spokesman for Joe Biden and Obama. This is Politico. Let me just finish two paragraphs here. Behind the scenes, however, Amazon and other companies have been making moves to help keep their taxes from rising. And their efforts illustrate some of the unseen hurdles the Biden administration faces, blah, 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 blah. The company hired the tax lobbyist, Joshua Odense, a former Democratic congressional aide and veteran of the Obama administration. They hired him last month to lobby on the section of the tax code dealing with the research and development tax deduction, according to a disclosure filing that Politico got its hands on. They just are, aren't they?
But doesn't this fit exactly with what we saw from the ExxonMobil piece on Channel 4.
Oh, yeah.
You see that, David?
Because yes.
ExxonMobil is just pouring out the corporate propaganda about how they're a green company. They're going to develop whatever kind of unicorn concept, carbon sequestration, and, pursue what is good for the environment. And all the time, every step of the way, they are fighting against everything.
With Shell corporations, and I don't mean Shell oil. They create all these phony think tanks, and then they hire people from the Obama administration to become lobbyists for oil, and the planet is dying. The planet is dying. We have to wrap it up.